ICTs, Innovation in Education, Mobile Learning and the Technology Affecting Humanity. In this communication, we are going to present our research proposal based on an extended time model in order to measure the mobile technology acceptance among primary education needs. We are going to follow an index based on the proposal for the track. We are going to begin with the context and motivation that drives the research. After this, the state of the art. Thirdly, the objectives and hypotheses that drive the investigation. Fourthly, the methodology of our proposal. And finally, the dissertation status and expected contributions. Mobile learning is a new methodology that tries to take advantage of the mobile devices in educational context. Its main advantages are the personalization, the mobility, the multimedia capacity of the devices, and the flexibility, making possible learning anytime, anywhere. Due to the spike of popularity that has experienced these kind of devices, there is a growing number of investigations on mobile learning, both from a technological and an educational point of view, covering a wide range of contexts. Also, the investigations from an educational point of view are still in a primary stage of development, and there are often isolated experiences with no continuation and not always successful. There are three main pilots when it comes to the mobile learning intervention success: the improvement of the didactic quality of the designs, the involvement of the administration and social partners, and the collaboration of the teaching body. The teachers are a key element in the integration of any informational system, and mobile devices are not an exception. We consider, therefore, essential to know which element drives them to the acceptance of mobile devices. The technology acceptance model proposed by Davis is a theoretical proposal based on the theory of reason action and the theory of thing behavior by Fishman and Eisen, which tries to analyze and predict the actual use of a technology, the acceptance of the same. It's based in two main contexts: the perceived usefulness, which is the degree to which a person believes in a particular system would enhance his or her performance, and the perceived ease of use, which is the degree to which a person believes that using a particular system would be preferable. These two concepts condition the attitude toward using, which is comprehended by the beliefs of a person. This attitude toward using condition the behavioral intention of using a system, and this behavioral intention condition the actual use. Davis recognized the existence of external variables that can affect perceived usefulness and perceived ease of use, but in its original model, he didn't depend on them. Also, he built an instrument based on a Likert type scale in order to analyze these five constraints through self report. The main advantages of the TAN model are its theoretical strength and adaptability, which makes it a widely explained model, which reliability and validity are contrasted and explain a relatively high percentage of the variables. There are also disadvantages, like the lack of deepening in the external variables and the data gathering to self-report that can affect especially the actual use of the system. In order to overcome this limitation, increase the percentage of the variance that this model explains or adapt it to new contexts, this model is frequently modified. The more frequent modification can be categorized in four groups: the inclusion of external precursors, the incorporation of factors suggested by other theories, the introduction of contextual factors, and the measurement of the final elements. Currently, this model is particularly widespread in the fields of commerce and ICTs, and it's also starting to be quite popular in the educational field, overall in the context of e-learning, lifelong learning, and higher education. In Spain, the use of TAM in the educational system is still in a primary stage of development, where we find few significant experiences of its use, and are overall focused in the fields of higher education and lifelong learning from the perspective of the students. We propose an extended TAM model with constructs from other theories in order to study the mobile technologies acceptance among primary education teachers, dealing with a problem that has to do with the teachers' acceptance of mobile devices as tools for the formal educational process. We propose three main objectives: to analyze the different models of technological adoption and the features that determine the process of acceptance of informational system, to develop a model of technological adoption that allows to delimit the factors that determine the use mobile technologies by the primary education teachers, and to evaluate the acceptance of mobile technology among the primary education teaching body of Castilla y León. The hypothesis of our investigation are that the teachers that perceive a higher ease of use and usefulness in mobile devices will present a more positive attitude towards the use, that the attitude towards the use of the teachers is positively related to the intention of using the technology, and this in turn is positively related to the actual use of such technology, that the teachers with more experience in the use of the mobile devices will present a more positive attitude towards the use, that the level of enjoyment with the use of the technologies is positively related to the attitude towards the use, and that the social factors, such as social norm or critical mass, can positively affect the attitudes towards the use of mobile resources by the teachers. The methodology that I'm going to follow is divided in four main activities. First of all, a literature review. We are going to perform a meta-analysis using a systematic literature review methodology. We are going also to build and validate an expanded TAM model in its instrument. And after this model is validated, we are going to use it to perform a quantitative study of the acceptance of mobile technology by primary education teachers of Castilla y León. This quantitative study will be complemented with a qualitative one with the same, in the same context. Currently, we have already built our theoretical model and instrument and are currently on the validation, validation status, and we have also contacted with the Junta de Castilla y León in order to gather the information necessary to conduct the sampling process, which we have recently finished. The main contribution that we expect to achieve with our investigation are the construction of an instrument efficient in order to diagnose and predict the acceptance of mobile technology by the education teachers, which will facilitate the integration of ICT in education. And also, we are going to conduct a research, two researches, one quantitative and one qualitative, that we hope will help us to increase the knowledge that we have on this subject. In conclusion, we would like to say that the integration of ICTs in education opens new methodological options, and the teachers constitutes a key factor in the adoption process. Therefore, a tool based on the TAM model can be useful in order to study the technology at the time. Thank you very much.